Hello, beautiful souls. Welcome back to this podcast. I'm Lais, your host. I'm an energy healer, a channeler, a writer, and I'm so happy to come back here with my team of channelers this month to bring you important messages, things to reflect on, to journal about, to shift your perspectives on things, or to help you shift an energy. As I said on the podcasts before, just take what resonates, leave out what doesn't. We all tap into different aspects of the collective mind. And so all our messages will be for certain types of people. And if nothing resonates, that's perfectly okay too. So this month, I have Bianca here again. Bianca is doing an actual exercise to help you how to do automatic drawing, to connect to your soul and to let your soul communicate through visuals, through images. And she's doing an actual exercise to demonstrate that. So for those of you on the podcast, I will link below the YouTube link in case you want to see what she's actually drawing. But yes, I hope for those of you who love drawing, who have artsy supply already at home, that you can dive right in and channel your own message for June, or just, you know, your own symbology of what your soul wants you to know or to feel right now. And then we have Samantha Thornhill here, poet, mystic, author, and her oracle card reading is out of this world this month. By the time she picked the third card, I was sobbing because it was really resonating deeply with that. I will be talking about something that happened to me yesterday as I was channeling. It's the return of the Divine Mother. So between the three of us, I really hope you find one message that really resonates at least. Dena Masfar is not participating this month. Of course, for those of you who already have been following this podcast, you will know she's Palestinian. And so this week particularly has been very heavy for her because, as you know, what is happening in Rafah. And so she's, you know, grieving. She is sitting with the pain that is coming up. And so I just, Dena, I wish you lots of healing. And of course, we're all here to hold space for you. All right. Having said all that, it's time to dive into our energy forecasts. And mine will be up next. So I think the souls that will benefit most from this message right now is the old souls. So if you identify as an old soul, and especially as a soul that has been here since not maybe the beginning of times, but already had numerous indigenous lives, if you can relate to that on an intuitive level, or maybe on an inner knowing that you had previous lives as an indigenous person, it's a message for you today. So what happened to me yesterday was I was going into meditation to ask, what is it that I want to channel for this month? What kind of guidance should come through? Suddenly I was joined by an energy that presented herself as the Divine Mother. And oh my God, just the second she arrived, there was just so much love, so much light. I haven't seen anything like this before. And the minute she arrived, I just started purging and tears just came. And comparing myself to that light, I just felt like I was a shadow. And I felt so unworthy of her love. I was in the state of, you know, what's happening? Why do I feel so unworthy of your love? And you know, at what point did that happen? At what point did I separate myself from the Divine Mother's love? And she presented herself. First of all, it was this radiant white light, but she had the face of my mother as she was younger, in her 20s, maybe by the time I was born, that kind of age. It was an energy that represented every single mother on earth. It was this collective energy of all mothers and the divinity of it. So what she's sharing with me is that many of us old souls who had indigenous lives before, we might feel tremendous pain right now because of what's happening in Palestine to the indigenous people of Palestine, because we feel the pain of what happened to us, what happened to our tribes, to our families, when we were slaughtered, when, you know, when our land was stolen by force. As I was purging that, I was seeing images of myself as an indigenous girl, numerous lives in the US, in Brazil. It was like so many collective past lives where I went through the same thing again and again, where my land was being colonized by the colonizers and my magic was eradicated, my life, my tribe. And I was just sitting there and allowing myself to purge that pain. And the next pain that came, which was quite interesting, is the pain of seeing myself in the mirror as a white woman nowadays, right, with a white body, and feeling like I have this indigenous soul that is so strong right now that wants to come through and just scream at what's happening in this world. And it's almost like this dissonance, right, when I look in the mirror and I see a white body and yet I feel so indigenous right now. And of course, you know, as we purge this, as we go through this, of course, at some point it will become less and less, but we need to purge, we need to go through this, we need to feel it all. And I was grieving just the loss of, you know, the magic that I was practicing there with being so close to nature and being able to commune with nature, with the Divine Mother again, right? Nature is the Divine Mother too. And the Divine Mother is here to guide us, to love us, to come back into our hearts. And so the message for June is really to allow that to happen, to allow ourselves to grieve collectively, to remember that we are all ancient souls in whatever bodies we chose now, whether it's a white body, whether it's a black body, whether we are still indigenous also in this life, to remember that we are all souls, that we most likely all have been indigenous at some point and lost our tribe, our land. So the theme for those of us who identify with all of this is the return of the Divine Mother, and the Divine Mother wanting to enter our heart spaces and just be filled with that unconditional, motherly, nurturing love that some of us might have been lacking in this lifetime. So some of you might be experiencing severe mother wounds coming up. Your inner child might be hurting. You might feel abandoned or rejected by your physical mother in this lifetime, or just the Divine Mother in general, this unconditional love. If you grew up without that unconditional love, or you have, you know, mother wounds for whatever reason, your inner child might be suffering and in deep pain. And so the message here is really to keep connecting to your inner child every single day and to ask, what is it that you need from me today? And to ask yourselves, I feel abandoned by the Divine Mother, by the Divine Love. How are you doubting your own divinity, your own magic? Are you doubting yourself to be a good parent, a good mother? Are you suffering because you think you're not, you know, good enough as a mother for your own kids? This is another way how it can show up as a wound. So I want you to actually place the palms of your hands on your heart chakra and just take three deep breaths. You can close your eyes. And now repeat after me. I am now fully ready to allow the Divine Mother's love to return into my heart space. I'm now ready to receive the Divine Mother's love. I am worthy of the Divine Mother's love. I am Divine Love. I am Divine Love. I am Divine Love. And now I want you to visualize being in a sacred space somewhere in nature, a place you already know or imaginary, it doesn't really matter. And just imagine and invite in the Divine Mother now and let her come in and present herself in any way she wants to present herself as an energy, a face. And as she steps in, just let her shower you with her divine love, her light, her motherly energy. And just allow your heart space to absorb all of that. And take one more breath in and exhale. And that is another visualization on top of the inner child one you can do, be it on a daily basis now or weekly, or at least some form of ritual that brings you healing, because that is what we all collectively need this month. Don't be afraid to feel too much. You know, there's so many of us who are sensitive souls, old souls, and we're being told we're oversensitive and we should just stay high vibe. But there's nothing more high vibe than being true to ourselves, our emotions, to purge, to cry, to be in touch with our souls, and all of that. It is just deeply healing, all of that. With all of that, there is this urge to return to the simple things in life, to simplicity. You know, many of us are tired of all these complexities in our lives, all these different things of hustle culture. And we just want a simple life, return to ease and grace and feeling grounded and one with nature. And spending time in nature is so important this month, even more so than usual. So go out, ground yourselves, spend time rooting in nature, going to rivers and lakes and oceans, whatever it is that you have close by. Because what I also channel is this urge to connect to our ancient wisdom as indigenous souls, where everything was sacred, every single sand corn, every single pebble was sacred. And to connect to that and to see the sacred in everything around us and to make space for that indigenous wisdom to come back into our souls. Because as I was journaling through this experience yesterday, it just became so apparent that if we don't see the sacredness of all the lands in this world, all indigenous lands in this world, and all the people, if we feel more sacred than other people, be it through religion, be it through other beliefs, how can we see ourselves as truly sacred if we can't see it in other people, right? So it's this beautiful process of recognizing that all lands are sacred. There's not just one holy land. All the lands are sacred. The land you are living on right now is sacred. And all the people are sacred, no matter what religion, no matter where they live, whether they are white, black, indigenous. They're all sacred. And so the Palestinians are sacred, very sacred too. And we need to remember that. If we think and we talk about oneness in spiritual circles, we cannot exclude the Palestinian people and their pain and their suffering. And we need to allow ourselves to feel that, to feel their pain. We are part of their pain, right? All right, that's all I have for you. And I hope that this message finds you well. If you're one of these souls who will be going through the same or already went through it, maybe you went through it before me, I would love it if you found me on social media or through email, through my website, and you would describe your experiences with this, what you are working through, what's coming up for you, and to have this discussion. So I feel like I'm not the only one here. But yes, thank you so much and have a beautiful June. Lots of love. Kisses.
Hello, beautiful people. My name is Bianca Petetel Flowers, and today I wanted to talk to you about how your soul speaks to you. When I was thinking about what I wanted to channel for this coming month, I was continually reminded about how the soul speaks to us in symbols and how the understanding of that symbolism is linked to us tapping into our own personal power. And so I wanted to share with you a technique that I use that is amazing for helping you to begin to access and understand the symbolism that your soul uses. This practice of automatic drawing that I'm going to show you is something that I have used for many, many, many years, and I find it incredible to help give me a read of what is going on for me or what is going on in the collective. So today I'm going to do some automatic drawing and we'll have a look at the symbols that are coming up for the collective. So it is best when you're doing the automatic drawing to have a really big piece of paper on a board that you can really express yourself well on. So the biggest piece of paper that you can. I like to use willow charcoal, which I also love to teach people how to make from scratch because I go through a lot of it. But any soft drawing medium will work for you. A soft pastel or some willow charcoal from an art supply store. Then what we want to do is we want to stand with our arm in the middle of our paper, and then we're just going to close our eyes and start to scribble. And we're just going to scribble and scribble and scribble and scribble until we feel like we've already done enough. All right. For me, I already could feel what this symbolism was before I even opened my eyes. Although there's some more things going on there now that I do open my eyes. But as I was doing this movement, what was coming through for me about what's happening at the moment is this big building of energy here. I might actually grab quickly some coloured soft pastel. So as I was drawing, there's this big explosion of radiant energy coming out here. It might be even some pinks. And this energy, as is expanding from the center of so many, many, many people, and it's meeting, what color will we use for that? The black's quite good, but a dark gray. It's meeting this band of heavy energy that's like keeping it in. That would be all the lower energies of the humanity and the earth plane that we are starting to see really clearly out in our communities, in the media, this holding down. But what is occurring in many, many, many people is this brilliant, blinding light that is sparking up and breaking through this layer that's been holding us back. And once that happens, this is all just going to start to fall away. And it's going to allow us a really strong, secure base to build from and to exist upon. So I love working in this way with this symbolism. It's something that I love to teach other people how to do. So if you would like to learn how to access your own symbolism and start to work with that on a daily basis in your life, feel free to reach out to me and you can sign up to my mailing list. I have a short course on that coming up very soon, which I'd love you to join me in because I would just love to share this. So I hope you're having an amazing, albeit challenging time as we are expanding into all that we can be, wherever you are in the world, and sending my love and heartfelt. I don't even know if there is an actual word I want to say condolences, sympathy, but none of that is at all adequate to the people that aren't having an amazing time, the people that are having an absolutely horrendous time at the moment, where their world is literally crumbling. May your heart shine through all of that awfulness, and that you very soon have a beautiful, strong base from which you can rebuild. Lots and lots of love to you all, and chat to you again next month. Bye.
Assalamu alaikum. This is Samantha Thornhill coming to you with your June energy forecast for your liberation. How can we propose to free Palestine?
when we haven't freed ourselves. Let's read for liberation. All right, so the first card, beautiful card, is Imhotep, visionary. Having a vision for liberation is the prerequisite for liberation. We cannot manifest something that we don't envision first. So when we say free Palestine, have we been able to envision what that looks like? Your soul's intention is to create a sort of pioneering change through implementing divinely inspired ideas. So there's no doubt that you've come to Earth to redesign something, because this Earth needs a lot of redesigning. And it's an all hands on deck situation. If you're a visionary, which you are, guided by the divine to implement a project that can help heal or inspire our world, what is stopping you from doing that? What do you want to improve or innovate? So if you're passionate about what needs to evolve, then you're the one that's there to make the difference. This is why you're here. We're each a puzzle piece in the cosmic puzzle of liberation. What part do you intend to play? There's something coming up around being able to fuse ancient methods with more innovative ones. We have more access to ancient wisdom than probably perhaps ever. And then there's the innovation, the new, the jiggy, that we also so have at our fingertips. Let's talk about the digital age, right? How do we create liberation, fusing the old and the new? Food for thought. The second card is Maulisa, balance. As we know, the road to liberation gets stressful. We become soul weary from bearing witness to events that we actually can't even imagine. In order for you to remain steadfast on this long road to liberation and freedom, we must center ourselves. And this is an outgrowth of doing what we need to do to care for ourselves. Take that nap, sit in that meditation, put down the phone just for a few minutes so that you can stare off into space. In the governance of our own lives and in rabble-rousing, it's very easy to feel scattered and pulled in every direction and just downright drained. So this is an opportunity to visualize your energies returning to you and call that energy back to you. It is so imperative that you maintain your personal balance. Yes, continue to allow your heart to crack open. Cracking open your heart is what will save your spirit from breaking. Allow your heart to crack open. Cry the tears. Let the pain of the world move through you. Welcome it. Allow yourself to imagine the heartbreak of another. This is part of bearing witness. It's holding that energy. I encourage this. And I don't encourage it at the expense of your longevity, because we need you. So you need to find your balance. When you know that your gas needle is going down and that you're not going to be good to anyone, you can be proactive in balancing your energies in the best way you know how. It could be swimming in the ocean and walking on the grass, earthing. It could be, you know, drinking more water to ground yourself into the earth. Whatever it is that you know that you need to do to bring yourself back into balance, this is the wisdom of Maulisa. She represents equilibrium, moderation, and peacekeeping. This is about remaining calm and composed. Now, there is such a thing as divine rage, and that is well within the conversation of balance as well. In the face of so much apathy, in the so much deafening silence, the divine and sacred rage does provide balance. But within that balance, you must balance yourself. It is a meticulous thing to know when it's time to get loud and when it's time to just produce actions. In the case of your personal governance, the balance that is being called for now is within your own life and within your own ability to keep the peace. This is not about fighting with people in your life about beliefs. You can feel for others and still protect your emotional balance. And this is part of the journey, is how do I let the world in and still do what I have to do for me so that I can do what I must do for the world. Third card is Hathor, soul family. Liberation is a collective aspiration. So how wonderful it is that this message of soul family slides up into this reading today, because this is about destined reunions. There are people that you have chosen to do this life thing with. And what's exciting about that is that there are people on their way to you, and there are people you are on your way to. And this is the family that your soul has chosen to travel with on this evolutionary haphazard journey back to the source. If you have been on a particular road and it's been lonely and it's been rocky and it's been dim and dank and dark, and you've looked around wondering, where are my people at? Know that this is a magical time of reconnecting with your soul family. Because in order for you to achieve the liberation that you have been yearning for, we need community. Maybe there is something that you're supposed to be building together. You don't need to overanalyze why you feel so seen and why you feel so supported by these people and why it seems to come so effortlessly to them. It just is, and it feels great. And this is what you have always been so deserving of. This card is here to assure you that your soul family does exist and they want you to shine brightly. Your success becomes theirs. Not only will they celebrate in your successes, they will also go out of their way to support you. Not only when it's convenient for them, and not only because you ask them to, but because they see you. And they genuinely want to make it easier for you. And you will do the same for them. Pay attention to everyone that you're meeting, beloved, because you never know where the road could lead. When you have met your soul family, when you have found that balance within yourself and with each other, and when you all share a common vision to create the world that hasn't been seen yet by people that are only seeing with two eyes. I hope you enjoyed this June energy forecast for your liberation. Again, I am Samantha Thornhill. I am the author of the Black Unicorn Journal of Passions. This is what I call a medicine book of journaling prompts for self-definition healing. And I'm also a poet and an educator and facilitator of the Black Unicorn Experience, as well as an oracle intuitive. So I am here for you. Please tap in with me if you ever want to have an individual session, or if you would like to do some journaling with me one-on-one. I do provide that service as well. So I look forward to hearing from you and hearing what comes of this month and what liberation looks like in the months to come. Free Palestine.
All right. That concludes all of our messages for the month of June. If you enjoyed any of the messages or part of the messages, do get in touch with us or the person with whom you resonated. Let us know what spoke to you. We always like to interact with you and to know what is, you know, happening in your lives, how our words are resonating or not. So let us know, get in touch. We would love to hear from you. Lots of love and happy month of June.